Today, I want to introduce you to a Google tool that can help you stay organized, on task, and ultimately more productive. It's called Google Tasks, and it allows you to add and manage your tasks across all of your devices. Now, one of my favorite things about this feature, and something I want to point out here, is that it's easy to access from inside your Gmail and Google Calendar accounts. So here I'm inside of my Gmail, and off to the right, I can see this icon for Google Tasks. Now, I'm not sure what to call it because I don't know what that is inside of there, but this is the Google Tasks icon. I'll click it, and it opens up this side panel that will show me all of my tasks. Now, in this case, I don't have any, but that's because we haven't added any tasks yet. Here, I'm going to add a task by going up at the top and clicking Add a Task. Then I'll title it TPS Reports. I can leave details down below that. And then I'll click off of it. So I'll click here, and we've just added that to our list of tasks. So if I want to close it out, that's fine. If at any time I wanted to go over here and check it out, no problem, there is that task. Now I'm going to add another one and show you another feature within this. And this one is going to be meeting with Ella. In here, I'm not going to leave any details, but this time I'm going to click on date and time. This needs to have a date and time because this meeting is at a particular time. So in this case, it's on Wednesday at 11 a.m. So I have that in here. I'll press OK. Now, before I do that, you can select repeat. And this would be if you were going to have it an event that occurs every day or let's say every week, whatever. In this case, this isn't recurring. So I'm actually going to go in here and I need to enter that again now. I'll put in that Wednesday, set the time to 11 a.m., press OK. And I've now added that inside of here. It's a second task that we have. And below it, you can see that it lets me know when it is. Now, I want to point out a neat feature with this. If I go over to my Google Calendar and we go look at September 1st, you'll notice here that there's that meeting. It has it inside of my calendar. And that's because tasks will sync with your calendar. Now, within Google Calendars, a neat feature is that you can drag things around and have them on a different day. So let's say, for instance, that Ella can't make the meeting on Wednesday, so we need to reschedule for Thursday. Well, I can simply just drag that and bring that right over here. Now, in this case, when I did that, I saw it change to 9 a.m., so I do quickly want to go in and just adjust that. But you'll see that when you do move any of your tasks in here, they will also update and change within that tasks bar. Now, if you use Gmail, you also have the ability to drag and drop emails into your tasks. This is probably my favorite feature because it's a great way to separate emails that you need to take action on or follow up on. So now I'm going to go to one of my emails, and I have here this one that says meeting community event. I'm going to click on this and hold it. And when I do and start dragging it, watch what happens. It says drop to create new task. And I can simply drop this email inside of there, and it adds that email here now. Now, I need to go in and add any details or a date and time if I want to, but it does add it over here. The great thing is that this is the point then where you're all set. This is where the fun begins, where you start accomplishing things and then crossing them off. And when you do, they will disappear off of your list. You can always go down to the bottom and see your completed tasks. So right now, I'll go down there, click on this, and you can see I have those here, the tasks that I've already completed. Now, there's a lot more that you can do with Google Tasks. Up here, you can create lists, so you could have these separated out maybe by a personal list, a work list, and so on. So there is a lot that you can do with this. I just wanted to introduce you to this feature. It's been around for a long time, but recently they've really improved it and integrated it within the GS Suite tools. I recommend checking it out.